whenever there will be there, you will get scared of investing in the market, where would you turn? To safety. And these are essentially some of the safest companies. And hence, you turn your face towards businesses which are very high on ethics, integrity, corporate governance, and right capital allocators.
One of your PMSs, which is coffee can philosophy, coffee can PMS.
Right.
So you were the first ones, right, correct, to come up with this term in India.
100%.
Right. So what the industry is aware about is the growth style of investing, you know, value style of investing. But you have pioneered coffee can style of investing and named as coffee can. It's kind of getting famous these days.
Correct.
So I would like to understand from you, you know, what was the history? How you discovered this? And what is your vision? Where do you want to take this?
Very interesting. So the reason why coffee can came into existence in India is thanks to Ambit. And what do we essentially want to achieve with this coffee can investing? It's very, very simple. We want to create a structure. We want to create a framework which allows a layman, which allows an educated person, which allows a retail investor, which allows a portfolio advisor, which allows an HNI or a super HNI, all to make money depending on their ability to invest. So we have, in literal terms, we have simplified investments. And how have we done it? Very, very simple, right? Just two simple ratios. 10% revenue growth, ROCE is greater than 15% for a decade or over a decade. Now, what does it say? These are very two simple ratios which anybody can do. But what does it say? It says two very simple things. Businesses which are defensible and businesses which have relatively inelastic demand. And I'm using a word, inelastic, which is an economics output term, which simply means that changes in the price does not impact the demand. Are there such kind of businesses? Yes. And if you invest in such kind of businesses, you do not have to worry what is the news outside, what is the QE, what is the trade wars, what is the crude prices, what is the rupee dollar movement. What you only have to focus on is the business which you are owning. And if you keep owning these businesses, and if you remain patient with these businesses, there is no way you can lose money. And the reason why you don't lose money is very simple. There are only two factors which impact the stock price. And there are only two things which you make, by which you can make money in equities. One is dividends, and the second one is stock appreciation or the price appreciation. Dividends is a very simple cycle, right? You have capital, you put that capital to work, and you have human assets and physical assets. You sweat these assets, you get top line or the revenue. From top line and revenue, you get the bottom line. That PAT is either reinvested, and if you do not have suitable opportunity, you give back to the people in the form of dividends. Very, very simple. All coffee can businesses are some of the highest dividend paying businesses. Why? Because they understand that if you can't use the capital well, it's better to pay back to the stakeholders, shareholders, rather than using the strategy of spraying and praying, which most businesses do. Another challenge which Indian businesses especially do is, for 4-5 years they remain focused, but as soon as they start generating free cash flows, their nephew comes, their son comes, their daughter comes, their family member comes, and they have other related interests, and you start spraying money on that. Here you can't do two simple tasks together, and you want to run two parallel different businesses, next to impossible. Hence, coffee can strategy says very, very simple thing. If you remain focused, you will constantly keep generating free cash flows, which will help you to pay dividends. The second is that how the price is determined is PE multiplied by EPS. So you can either focus on the PE or on the EPS. In very, very layman terms, PE is something which we can't control. Price to earning multiple is something which changes second to second. And that's how the stock prices change. Can I control that? The answer is no. Hence, what I should do is look for businesses where the EPS growth has been consistent year after year. And which businesses will deliver? Which have defensibility and against disruption, and which have inelastic demand against any economic environment. And that's about it.
It's a simple strategy, and I think simple is scalable, and that is working very
100%.
Well. And that is where it is one of the highly acclaimed and good performing PMSs for last 18 months in market time.
Exactly.
Were not conducive, and they were tough.
Correct.
So apart from coffee can philosophy, right? So you have another product which is Good and Clean.
Correct.
Which is in the mid cap space.
Correct.
And in fact, mid caps have got hammered in last 18 months. But it has shown great amount of resilience. So, there, I think, it's not just basis the simple strategy. There is some investment philosophy that you guys have followed in picking right mid-cap companies. So I would like to understand from you, that what is the investment philosophy that you follow behind Good and Clean PMS?
Sure. So in Good and Clean, what are two or three things which any business should follow? One, it should have its own core competency, core practices by which they should derive its strength. It can't be political linkages. So companies which do not have any political linkages, companies which are clean in terms of accounting, companies which do not have related party transactions, companies which do not have bureaucratic linkages, companies where the suppliers or their major suppliers or buyers are their family members, if you exclude all of them, because these are the challenges because of which the smaller companies sometimes or the mid-cap companies sometimes cannot scale up. They lose their way out, and we remove all of them. So Good and Clean have two features, Good and Clean. Clean, as I explained to you, no political linkage, no bureaucratic linkage, no related party transaction, clean books of accounts. And Good essentially means businesses which are with limited debt or declining debt to equity ratio or zero debt. Our preference is always zero debt, to have ROCEs which are north of 15-16% and EPS growth again which is higher than 15-16%. So essentially good capital allocators. Businesses which know, which realize that there are only two things which are limited in this world. Limited capital, limited human bandwidth, and which allocate both of it in a judicious manner to increase their ROE and ROTI, return on time invested. If they keep following on these two principles diligently, you would see that during bad times they will not fall. And that is the reason in last financial year when mid cap index was down, and I'm talking about last financial year, which is 18-19, mid-cap index has been down by 7-8%. Our Good and Clean mid-cap fund was up by 18.5%. No other mid-cap fund in the industry was up. And we were the only ones. And simple reason, whenever there will be fear, whenever there will be noise, whenever there will be there, you will get scared of investing in the market. Where would you turn? To safety. And these are essentially some of the safest companies. And hence, you turn your face towards businesses which are very high on ethics, integrity, corporate governance, and right capital allocators. And that's how you'll perform.
So that's good to understand. But no other PMS would look for companies which are not good, which are not clean. So your name does say that.
Sure.
But there is definitely some secret which is beyond just good and clean, right? So
right.
Everyone understands that companies should not have political linkage, right?
Right.
There should not be third party transfers. So all these data is available to all other fund managers
also.
Correct.
Correct.
Right. And when it comes to understanding the good part, which is your EPS, earning growth, you know, order book, all these things are available
sure.
to everyone else.
Sure.
But the disparity in the returns, where mid-cap index has fallen by 7%, you have given, you know, 18.5% return, it cannot be just, you know, similar thing.
So very, very simple. We follow this practice to the T. So you are absolutely right. Every fund manager knows about it. But for them, the greed to generate that extra return forces them to compromise on the underlying principle. And we are extremely process oriented. We are extremely high on process and our framework. If our framework says that the company is not clean, irrespective of the growth it is showing, irrespective of the revenues it is showing, irrespective of what is the market commentary, irrespective of the promoter, we will not touch that. For us, the rigor is for last 6 to 7 years, we want that consistency, we want that cleanliness, we want that good corporate governance. Most fund managers, as you are rightly saying, know about it. It's not something we are doing unique. And hence I said, both the philosophies, whether coffee can, whether good and clean, can be replicated by even a layman. Forget him, forget a fund manager. The problem is, when there is buoyancy of 2017 post demonetization, did you compromise on these ethics and integrity? Because you were chasing momentum, you were chasing consistent flow of money rather than sticking to your process. And hence, you, when the market punishes, it punishes very badly. We are very happy during buoyant times if we perform in line with the market or relative underperformance. But our simple strategy and philosophy for coffee can or for good and clean midcap is to protect your capital during bad times. We have to reduce your base. And very, very simple example. In 2008, we were not present with our funds, but just using an analogy here, Sensex corrected by 52% in calendar 2008. So if you would have invested 100 rupees, 100 rupees would have become 48 bucks. Next year, even if you would have gained 100%, you are still falling short of your principal. Whilst if coffee can and good and clean would have only had cuts of 15%, which means your 100 rupees would have become 85, and next year, even if they perform 75%, while the index has doubled, I'm still giving significant outperformance, significant positive returns. That's the whole idea. The equity investing is not increasing the risk and then generating the returns. The good and clean and coffee can philosophies focus on reducing the risk and then generating the return. Can I, for every percentage of returns incrementally generated, reduce the marginal risk associated with that return? And that's what all we focus on.
Basically, acumen is at work.
100%.
Right.
100%.
Thank you so much, Siddharth, for your time. It has been a pleasure talking to you. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Kamal, for having me. I'm sure that my few words will help not only people who have money, but people generally at large to identify businesses, not only to create wealth, but to protect their wealth as well. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Thanks.